Good evening, Internet. I'm Jesse. I'm also known as Tango, and I stream for Extra Life. Extra Life is a charity organization that partners gamers like me with local Children's Miracle Network hospitals to raise money for kids in need. The concept is as simple as their slogan: play games, heal kids. We do this because it's time to change kids' health, because kids can't wait. Kids are the future. By giving kids a brighter tomorrow, a brighter next week, next month, next year, everyone gets a brighter future, because kids are the future. If you donate to the link at the top of the screen, the money will go directly to a Children's Miracle Network hospital here in Colorado. That money, that donation is tax deductible. If you're catching this live, there's special incentives running through November 6th. If you're catching this on the follow-up, hey, anything you donate helps. I don't have any other special incentives running right now, but if you want to help me pay for such incentives in the future, check out the link at the bottom of the screen. It's my Ko-fi page, and half of all donations to my Ko-fi page go to pay for incentives for Extra Life. Right. Before I get started, couple of things. One, this is a grind night because I have died on this boss horribly quickly, and having looked at resources online, I need to dramatically change my approach to fight the boss that is right inside that door. The second thing is that my phone may be noisy this evening. I helped run a very successful event last night, and the relevant Twitter is blowing up. Third and not least, this is a warning for sadness. I do have a friend messaging me right now on the side. He and his husband had not been living together for a bit, due to just situations with work and relocation and timing and health. His husband got up here about 2 weeks ago, bringing the last dog in the family out. That dog has suffered some significant loss of health, and unfortunately, the humane thing to do is probably going to happen Tuesday. So if you see me stop and poke at the thing, that's part of why. Alright. So the recommended strategy for this fight is one of you has levels of burden. You. I just need to go get... I don't think I can afford... Huh, that's honestly better than I expected. The recommended strategy is to have 3 Dragoons and a healer, because you basically just keep your Dragoon off the screen to avoid the mass attacks. Oh, that hurt. So did that! White page get back to the airship and rest for free. That was a lot of painful. Diamond helmet is an improvement for both of you. That's good to know. Oh, I need to get him out of the back row. Make a huge difference. White Mage is in the back row and taking half damage. I gotta get enough money to turn my knight here into another dragoon. could be a problem. Hello! Grind money, it's ridiculous. That was some unfortunate timing. Apparently, once I beat the boss that's right inside this door, I get access to the Earth Crystal and I get a better healer than a white mage. round win. I didn't notice the fighter died. So much grinding. After Final Fantasies 1 and 2, where you just wind up with a ridiculous amount of money, this hurts. Oh no, I've run out of magic. Protect spell, which I know is for sale in some place. Not an airship specifically, but somewhere on this map. Oh no, I forgot to reset that! made a poor choice. Hurts the most when they don't even get to low health. Oops. They just die. Buy the next set of armor. $40,000 for Reflecting Kiraja? That's a problem. I'm going to assume the first one got a critical hit. How's that coming? I will say, I appreciate that in the Pixel remasters, and probably most of the releases, re-releases since the original, they have made grinding relatively trivial. I don't have to push a button every time. I just have to pay enough attention to not let the characters die like they just did. It does appear, that row impacts whether or not the goons do full damage. I would not expect jump would be impacted by row. If you're not familiar with the row system in Final Fantasy, at least this kind of Final Fantasy system, thrown weapons, bows, and magic do full damage front or back row, but you take less damage from physical attacks in the back row. So it is completely normal to take your primary healer or someone who lives exclusively on magic and drop them in the back row and have somebody else do all the rest of the hard work. Of staying alive. Jump being a physical attack, but also one where you literally can't be harmed or helped while you're not on the screen. I'm honestly surprised it's impacted with that. And the White Mage is dead again. Sorry, someone just answered a question with something I was really not prepared for. A friend of mine and my husband's, literally the guy we lived with for a month when we first moved here, and when he was in the process of selling his house back in Virginia, before he moved out here, he lived with us for a couple of months. His dad had come out to visit, and had hurt himself. He slipped on an escalator or something. After a couple days, he finally wound up going to the hospital because just the pain was bad, and while he was in the hospital, he picked up a fever or something. I noticed he was active. I'm like, hey, how's your dad? His dad's still with us, but significant memory loss? I'm like, what? This is not remotely in the list of answers I was expecting. I know this is a really downer of an episode, recording, stream, etc., with all the things I've just brought up recently. And I'm sorry for that, especially since I think this is going to be airing on YouTube like the week before Christmas. I need a combat log. I mean, I suppose I could just go look at the video. Is that a 5-digit number? Because that shouldn't be possible. Over here at the bad news is I can't afford Protect. The good news is I know where to go get it. I can now almost afford protect. Let's do that. I can now afford the protect spell. Okay, I'd forgotten how weak those were. I knew they were weak, but... East, not northwest. Wait, what was the building on top center of the map? Oh, I picked Raze at the time. That would do it.
Thank you.
Spirit told me there was a town in the mountains. Town in the mountains? Haha. What?
Thank you.
that wasn't what I was looking for, but okay. I think I tipped at that boss and figured if I need to keep grinding. I've got a good 15 minutes left of stream. Thank you. we hope that they stay alive. Or that the thing dies soon. I feel like I should go outside and save the game for real. But of course there's a maze. End it here, folks. Thank you for watching. Thank you for supporting Kids in Need. Stay safe and healthy out there. I will catch you all next time.